Google has made a subtle change to their helpful content guidelines, which basically changes everything. Let me tell you about the differences first, and then we can discuss what it means for your website and generating content. Here's what the old guidelines said. It said, Google Search's helpful content system generates a signal used by our automated ranking systems to better ensure people see original, helpful content written by people for people in search results. Notice the key here being written by people. Now, here's what the new guidelines say. It says, Google Search's helpful content system generates a signal used by our automated ranking systems to ensure people see original, helpful content created for people in the search results. So Google has basically removed the sentence where it says original content written by people. So kind of signaling where it's saying AI content is okay to use on your website. But that does not mean that you can start using AI content completely on your website. That does not mean anything like that. So here's how you should interpret these changes to Google's helpful content guidelines. Google is saying that AI content is okay to use on your website as long as it is original content, it is helpful content, it is technically correct content, and also reviewed by experts. So it's not saying that, hey, just go and find the most generic content you can create with any AI tool and just paste it on your website. Google is kind of saying that it's okay to use some of the AI-generated modules of content, or some of the content can be AI-generated as long as it fulfills all of these guidelines. So it doesn't mean you have to completely replace all your content with AI content, but you can start using some modules or some of the AI tools to supplement your content strategy. Now, here's how to put it in action. At WP Beginner, we've been integrating AI into our tools way before Google actually made this change. One example of it is all-in-one SEO. We have an integration with OpenAI in all-in-one SEO where you can generate AI-generated titles or AI-optimized titles for your blog posts. All you have to do is connect all-in-one SEO with OpenAI using the API key, and then all-in-one SEO will connect with OpenAI, use their neural networks, use their language models, and generate helpful titles that you can use for the most optimized performance on your blog post. We have a lot of other products also integrated with AI. For example, we have Uncanny Automator, which can help you even create images right inside WordPress. You can check out both of these products linked in the description if you want to check out the AI features. And if you want us to create specific videos around these AI features, let me know in the comments as well. And of course, as time passes on, we'll integrate more and more AI-related features into the rest of the product line where it makes sense. If you have any specific requests, you can let us know in the comments as well. So the summary of all these changes is that AI is here to stay. Google is making peace with AI content, but is still saying don't completely replace your content strategy or your content writer with AI. Supplement your content strategy with AI. Make it helpful, make it completely reviewed by experts, make it original content, and also make sure it's technically correct. As long as you are fulfilling those guidelines, you can start using AI content on your website. I'm personally very, very excited by this change, and at WP Beginner, we are running a lot of experiments on seeing how we can integrate AI into our products to make your life easier. This is Yuvraj from WP Beginner. If you have any questions, suggestions, make sure to leave in the comments. Otherwise, you can like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.